Welcome back, my beauties. We are here with another YouTube nail tutorial. I just wanted to insert a little clip of the previous set I did on myself of me polishing and how it like fully looked. Because I think on the other video, we did like a one hand, but I want you to see how both hands look in the process. And these are how it turned out. And these are some of the items that I used for this nail set to achieve it. I didn't put them all in there because I already had majority of the stuff put up. But next time, I'll have everything out and linked in the description box. I'm slowly but for surely getting there for you guys. But anyways, you guys, Happy New Year's. Yes, it's 2022. Yes, we bringing in a new year. Okay, now that color red that I just showed you is custom red acrylic that I made because I didn't have any red acrylic, so I had to use chalk, red chalk, to achieve that look, and it turned out wonderful, and I've been using it since. today video, after this clip is done, today's video is going to be me working on my mannequin hand, and I'm doing the marble ombre nail set. I'm doing both marble and ombre. I'm doing the marble set with the gel polish and the ombre with the acrylic powder. And I want you guys to really look at how I did it because it's very easy. Anyone can do it. It's very beginner friendly and very beginner easy to do. I want y'all to see step on step on how I achieve these beautiful nails that I did on my mannequin hand. And of course, you know, I added some little details into it because, you know, I'm always extra, y'all. But yeah. If you want to know how I achieve this look, stay tuned. Okay. Right here, I'm just showing y'all on the tablet, like how my nails look with the tablet. So if I was wearing, because you know how us girls it. When we get our nails done, we always got to either tap the table, tap the keyboard, tap the wall, or tap a tablet in the phone because we be just feeling ourselves with the, you know, with the tablet and stuff because our nails and stuff be done. So I just wanted y'all to see how it would look, you know, if when you achieve this look. It's real easy to do, you guys. Okay, so right here, as you see, I am putting the gel polish. First, I put the Bloomin' Gel on because it's like the Bloomin' Gel. And then after I put the Bloomin' Gel on, I put the white, blue, and pink gel polish side by side on each other. And then I take my dotting tool and I marble that in. And then as you see me right here, I'm polishing it with the Bloomin' Gel. I'm putting the Bloomin' Gel polish on the nails now. This is how I start off the whole acrylic application. You don't cure this. You do not cure it. As soon as you put on the Bloomin' Gel polish, you do not cure it. Because you want that gel polish to stick on while it's still wet. So that way it can start blooming into like the design of the marble that you want. I call this a cheat way of doing it. If you don't want to do the acrylic, because sometimes that acrylic get hard to ombre. Don't get me wrong, it really does. It depends on if you have a fast drying monomer or a fast drying polymer, you know. So with gel polish, it's so convenient. And with the Bloomin' Gel, it just helps it out even more because it helps create that design, that marble effect. And as you see, I'm picking up, after I do the dotting tool, I'm picking up with a gel brush. And I'm just putting it on there. I'm just putting it on there. I'm sorry that I did not get a close-up on this, y'all, but I'm trying to do it as much as I possibly can detail for you guys, but as you see, I'm putting it on there. But I'll have like some close-ups of when I do the ombre. And after you get done, you want to make sure you fill in all the spaces, the clear spaces that you see in there. But at the same time, you want to make sure your sidewalls and your edges and your free edge is white on the sides and in the front, which is your free edge, because you do not want it to become bulky when you get ready to cure it. I mean, even though you can go back over it after you do your acrylic, because you got to foul it anyways, but that'd just be doing too much work. So you don't want to do all that. As right here, I'm showing you guys how it turns out. You can barely see it. I don't know why I didn't zoom in. I wasn't thinking. I'm sorry, guys. Next time I'll get better on it. But right now, I just put it off in the lamp, and I let it cure for about 30 minutes. And I only do it for 30 minutes just to make sure that gel polish is dry enough for me to get ready to do the acrylic application. You guys, this is pretty self-explanatory. It's really, really easy to do. Really, really easy to do. Okay. Now, right here, this is where I get ready to do my ombre. As you can see, I'm putting on the nude ombre on top of it because the gel polish at this point had already cured. So now all I'm doing is ombreing that in. And all you're doing is just moving your brush ever so gently. You don't have to be rough with it, you guys. And you just keep ombreing that in. It doesn't have to be super perfect because you still want that marble to show as well as the nude too. And then when you get done with that, you're going to get ready to cap it. I always say cap it with either a pink translucent polymer or a clear polymer. Only because you want to make sure you do, especially with this gel polish, you want to make sure you do not mess up the design. You want to make sure you cap everything in. You want everything to set in place. And you guys, I cannot stress this enough. Make sure you wipe off your sidewalls. Same way with acrylic too. Make sure you wipe off your free edge, your cuticle area, and your sidewalls. Because you want to make sure every application is neat and perfect. Trust me, sometimes I still struggle a little bit trying to do it. But you want to do the same thing when you're applying on your polish too. You want to make sure your cuticle area is the main thing, because polish gets in between your cuticles and it bleeds through. So you want to make sure as you're going, the way my teacher taught me to do it when I was in school, guys, was to take a cleanup brush. As soon as you polish on there, as soon as you make a mistake of getting even just a little bit of polish on the cuticle area, you want to hurry up and get your brush and dip it in acetone and clean it off right then. Because if you wait the last minute, well, with gel polish, it's not going to matter because it doesn't cure. But like if you was to do regular polish, you can't. You have to do it right then, because if you wait, it's going to take forever to take that polish off, because by then it had already dried on your cuticle area. And y'all, it takes me a minute. It takes me a minute on this simply because I was running, like I was really running out of monomer. I have to get me some more, y'all. But it takes me a minute to kind of adjust to this because I'm trying to figure out how to get that nude to show up, because the nude is so freaking, it's almost like translucent almost. And with that ombre, you don't want it too pigmented. You want it just enough to where you can see a little bit of that marble come out, so that way it can look like it just all level out the same. It's gonna be a pretty long video, y'all. I'm sorry, but this is just step by step on how I do it. And you just keep washing it then.
mean the world to me. That's why I can't keep you in a situation where I can hurt you. Can I talk to you?
Okay. First of all, I wanna tell you that all I do is have love for you. No matter we go separate ways, I still ride for you. Cause you're the truth. Can't be replaced. You're the type of girl that make a nigga go out and get the ring. But the problem is, I'm not positive that I can give the commitment that you're asking for. Cause right now I'm young, and though you're the one, I can't guarantee that I can be the one you want.
Someone who is faithful.
I'm not admitting I can't do it, just don't wanna put you through it. She may holler, I may holler, but I wouldn't wanna do that to you, know.
I'll be cheating you if I continue to see you, cause you're ready to get serious. I'm not, cause I'm too curious. I'd rather keep it real and tell you how I feel. Cause I think you're beautiful and I don't listen to hurt you, know.
See, over and over again, I keep on saying to myself, I must be going out my mind tonight. I wanna spend all my time with her. Cause I love you more than to game your heart. Cause I know that I'm not ready
to lock it down for a time. Settle down with one time. Spend the rest of my life with you.
Oh, it's better to cry now than to hate me later. Trust me, I've had a broken heart before. And
I know just how you
feel. And knowing time it will.
Okay, guys, right here, I'm just kind of like showing y'all the brand of acrylic that I use for the nude. It's by what? I can't remember their name. Beauty something. Anywho, but that's the color nude that I want y'all to see. And now I'm just getting ready to cap it with the pink, translucent pink. I'll be back, guys.
I get dirty thoughts about you. They get worse when I'm without you. Does that mean that I'm going to hell? Or are you thinking them as well? Whoa. When I'm lonely, all the corners of my mind start racing. Things that should be kept in the basement. Spend my time trying to erase them. But when you hold me, in the fantasy it's so convincing. I shouldn't think the things I'm thinking, but now I've gone and let them sink in. The more that I push them away, the more that you're stuck in my brain. The more I mentally undress, I confess. I get dirty thoughts about you. They get worse when I'm without you. Does that mean that I'm going to hell? Or are you thinking them as well?
Again, y'all, I'm showing y'all how the nails will look with the tablet. You know, I just wanted to test it out to see. This is before I start the fouling process, but I just wanted y'all to see because, you know, I like showing off my nails. But, yeah, this is before I get started on fouling. And I'm about to get ready to start on the fouling. And I was so upset, y'all, because I was really looking for a spider. Like, after my fouling and stuff and buffing, I was really looking forward to doing, like, a spider gel look a little bit. But I didn't have any, like, as you see, the little container, the small pink container right there next to me, didn't have any inner spilt out. So I have to order some more white spider gel. I was so upset. But, hey, I improvised and just came up with a different design. But right here, you see me fouling. And And I caught myself trying to zoom in for y'all, but then I noticed that when I zoomed in too close, it kind of cut my hand off a little bit, so you couldn't really see it, you know? But you get the drift. And then here I go buffing the nails. Buffing each one because you want to make sure you buff it real smooth to get it ready for the application. For the polish, the clear polish application, gel polish application. Okay, so right here I'm doing the clear gel polish application. And after I do that, you will see me go in with some doing some detail line works. So if you want to see how I do that too as well, I'm going to do a video of me doing like some more nail designs in depth. And what I'm going to do is try to zoom in a little bit closer and get a good angle for you guys to be able to see how I do the designs. But after I get done curing this clear polish, then that's when I go in with my nail art. Y'all, this was a challenge because I was like, I didn't know if it was going to be a fail, but it ended up being a real good one because I wanted to do a different color simply because I had already did red and white on my nails and it turned out beautifully. But I wanted to add like some color on my mannequin's hand to see how it turned out, you know? And so you're just going to keep seeing me polish. And now I'm getting ready to cure it. And then I'm getting ready for the nail art. Here we go with the nail art. Want y'all to keep watching and please like, share, and subscribe, and comment if you please. And I will continue to keep bringing you guys more videos. I am going to do my prize giveaway. I just hadn't, like, got a chance to get to everything yet because of the holidays. But I am going to do my press on giveaways. And who knows, I might end up making, like, a little ombre nail set for y'all. Ombre marble nail set for you guys to give away, too, as well. So I'll make sure I get on that. I have like a couple of giveaways. I'm going to have one that's like a real long nail set. And then one that's like a regular size. And then one that's a short. So that way, you know, you can choose which one you want. But I think the game that I'm going to do is guess my favorite color. I think that's what I'm going to do. And I have to figure out how to set that up for you guys. But when I get to it, I'll get to it. I'm telling y'all, it's just since the holidays happened, I just kind of been behind on a whole lot. So I'm just now trying to get into the move and groove of things since, you know, since I'm not at school now, right now at the moment. So, but just continue watching and I'll be back. Okay guys, we are reaching the end of this video. I wish I could speed it up. I don't know how to quite speed up the videos just yet. I gotta kind of get used to being on YouTube. But this is the end of the video. Please like, share.